anyway. So to celebrate the fact that I've now got 500 subscribers, so that's 500 subscribers, at least maybe 100 people click on the video and watch the first 5 seconds.
Hey Cortana, volume down.
They don't want to watch this video because it's very boring. It's just me talking to a camera with a blue screen.
Ooh, hey Cortana, turn off.
Edit something there behind me with chroma key.
Yes.
It's not very well lit, so quite hard to do it.
Hey Cortana, on. It's a vlog. Finally. You do not know how many months since I got my Xbox One X last Christmas. I've been meaning to get this adapter for so long, despite the prices of variants. But I'm actually pleased that I got this. It is nice to play the Kinect now that I got it, even though it's mostly voice gestures. I'm not going to be an ILL streamer nonetheless, but I thought it was great to pick this up. But I mentioned about all the various pickups I got throughout the week. There's this and that, I should say. But other than that, though, I just want to quickly mention and congrats to Crew Lord Toff for reaching 500 subscribers, even though it's a different channel he's currently on. But he has many accounts, I should say. I just want to quickly congrats you. Bit of a shout out there. Anyways, hi, I'm Stephen Walken, Steety Films. It's a vlog. So for this vlog, even though, fun fact, I was originally going to do a particular vlog, an out and about vlog, because, you know, I'm trying to do some out and about kind of vlogs, despite my mental issues, all different topic. But yeah, originally though, I was going to go into town, go be like, oh, I got some Microsoft credit for towards the Destiny 2 expansion, which I have done today. But however, there was a major thing that happened in my local town area. I mentioned quite a bit on the clip. But other than that though, I just came back and I was still a bit shaky afterwards, despite this and that, when I was in town. But yeah, despite that though, rolled the VT. Morning all, it's currently, well, gone past 8 a.m. in the morning, and we thought we'll go for a little check. Hello there. Anywho, but yeah, we're going on a little walk yesterday, long going to town this morning. Oh, is there a new video game that's coming out today? No. Something really special has happened in my local town area that I'm going to this morning, alone, taking this route where it's a bit quieter, because usually I go a different route to town. But I'm taking this route despite it's a little bit quieter to do this sort of thing. But yeah, but something special is happening in my local town area, because long story short, quite a few months back, we have two major video game stores, Game and Granger Games, and they recently shut down quite a few months ago, and it's a bit daunting for the community for not having a video game store. Now don't get me wrong, knowing me, I do shop all around the place and take advantage of them, like Smith's, the supermarkets, and whatever when it comes to video games, but it's just that convenience alone, you know, having, you know, video games in a whole, and it's a bit of a shame when both of them got shut down, even though it's quite funny, actually, why they both shut down at the same time, because it's funny, because my mum chatted to one of the formal staff members in Game, because he works in a charity show. Hi, if you are watching. But other than that though, he told my mum about reasons why Game shut down in the first place, along Granger Games at the same time, because of Game shut down because they were competing, you know, with Granger Games, CEX, etc. Some of the shops in my local town area. Hello, doggies.
Hi, cute little doggies.
Anywho, but other than that though, yeah. So, Game shut down when, you know, competing with other stores, so it makes sense to shut down, because you don't want to compete with other stores, I should say. Then during the same time, and Granger Games shut down, not only in Grimsby for Granger Games, but all around the UK, and it was really, including myself, because I really enjoy Granger Games. Because I do like most of the staff, because I have a really good communication with the staff. Don't get me wrong, I do enjoy some of the staff in Game, even though one of the staff members in Game felt fallen out with me, and long story short. But I don't mind the staff in Game, it's just just this and that, even though the prices in general can vary. Because sure, Game is a bit overpriced, and I totally agree with that with most people, even the reasons why I like going to Granger Games is another thing, but it's just the merch. in-game they kind of have, because I've got my Tracer shirt on today, as well as my Game Boy bag that it'll be soon be my year anniversary since I got my Game Boy bag, and just reasons why I enjoy some of the stuff that they have in game, merch wise etc, just little things I like in game. But yeah, since game got shut down, it was really daunting for the community, and it's not saying most people could shop around, because Abo got time for that to shop around, and because I shop around quite a lot, because I really do enjoy walking around, no pun intended, just walking on my travels, walking to place, going to shop to shop, looking for the various bargains, I should say, but I just enjoy the walks, and just looking forward to a proper video game store coming back, I should say. It's great for the community, for the for them to have a proper video game store back, because there's just reasons why, and it was all blown up on their Twitter feeds, because I need to follow Game in Grimsby on their Twitter page. But yeah, overall, despite that, we're going there today because it's their actual open day today, since after the past few months since they closed down, along with Granger Games. I don't think Granger Games is going to ever come back. We're going to miss them. Oh, speaking about Granger Games, as the Granger Games staff, heard some of the staff from my local Granger Games might be working there, which makes sense. Go get that pay, wages, I should say. Sorry, all jokes aside, but other than that though, I'm looking forward to seeing how it goes, looking for it to be reopened, and I don't even know, it's quite early because it doesn't open till 9, but they're doing some really cool special offers for the first day of opening, and I'll just leave it at that, and we'll just let me enjoy the rest of my walk, and we'll go to town and see how it goes. But yeah, since a little bit early, I nipped in £2 Shreddies. I got a 29 pence Monster. These go for like £1. But you know me in terms of my budgeting skills. But I need a little something to keep me going for this morning. So I thought I'd grab that, even though a little bit tad early. It's only, it's nearly 8:30. But I thought I'd grab that while I'm on my travels. Hey.
You go, take one. There we go. Here you go, mate.
Thank you.
Can't get it. There you go, mate.
Thank you.
No worries. Fantastic.
Just like plenty of deals.
Do you want a selfie with us in it?
No, I'm alright, thank you. I'm just waiting for it to scroll to Destiny, because I picked up some Microsoft credit for towards the Destiny 2 expansion. No, sorry, I'm just waiting for it to scroll.
Bye.
Yeah, I've been to Game to pick up some Microsoft credit, mainly for the Destiny 2 expansion at the moment, but I had a nice time, even though it was quite a bit crowded. But other than that though, I'm going to go back home, and even though it's normal hours now, for town, I should say, but yeah, it was this and that. I'll share some pictures from Grimsby's Twitter, but yeah, other than that though, yeah, I just had a nice time and whatnot, and just I had a bit of a browse. There was some stuff there, but at least I've been out and did this and that, I should say, then is getting some Microsoft credit towards the Destiny 2 expansion. But yeah, overall, I think it was a good opportunity to go into town while, doing this vlog, is a whole different topic. But yeah, if you guys in the local area are watching, hi, and for those people that bump into people, even though I had a quick chat with someone who had the polo shirt that was in the photo of the line photo. But yeah, other than that though, I had a nice time. I was really quite anxious. I knew there was going to be people there, despite going to comic conventions or a different topic. But I did bump into quite a few people, well, close to bumping into people I quietly know. But yeah, it was a good time nonetheless. Even I'm back home now, I'm in my comfort zone. There's going out, I should say. But yeah, speaking about going out, I've been somewhere last Friday, because I mentioned quite briefly on my last vlog that I've been to Scunthorpe, because I rarely go to Scunthorpe than it is whether shopping around Scunthorpe, as I mentioned briefly on my last vlog. But yeah, last Friday though, I've been to Scunthorpe and I got some various pickups, even though I have got my eye on a particular something, which I mentioned about a bit. But yeah, knowing my mum, even though, oh, you don't go to Scunthorpe, but here, have some spending money. Oh, thanks, mum, because I had my eye on this, because I was looking on them CX's website, and there was various things I should get while I'm in Scunthorpe. There were some alright things, but I ended up getting this, though. I was after for one of these for ages, even though it was quite funny, because I was looking on CX's website, despite you know, how much these go for, alone, nearly 100 to 150 odd pounds, because the prices were vary since, you know, Microsoft discontinued these adapters, and the price went up, and I ended up getting this in CX in Scunthorpe for £50, even though when I looked on the CX's website, huh, they're £50 now, I might as well snag one of these while I can. So yeah, thanks, mum, for the spending money mostly towards this. But it was a good opportunity to get this, and it's nice to have the Kinect back up and running and do my voice gestures, even though I can't say, hey, can I turn it on? Hey, can I turn it on? Ha! You have no adapter. I can't do the thing. But yeah, I'm actually pleased with this, and I can actually use my Kinect again. I know I'm like one of those people that uses a Kinect, but I'm actually one of those people that uses the Kinect, if that makes sense. So yeah, I'm pleased with about that. Oh, it's quite funny. Someone actually labelled that, the Kinect. Thanks, because the label... all the other plugs, despite, you know, but yeah, thanks to EX and Scunthorpe for labeling this, so that saves me a job. But yeah, thanks, I doubt that some people in CEX in Scunthorpe will watch this, but yeah, thank you for the opportunity to make me purchase this. But while I was in Scunthorpe, you know, there are some other stores in Scunthorpe. I've been to Game, despite there was not much in the Scunthorpe Game, despite bumping into that certain someone I mentioned, because she does work in the Grimsby Game, despite she works at the Scunthorpe Game. I won't talk about it, alone falling out with people. Well, I'm not saying falling out with people. People fall out with me, then it's me pouring out with them. I'm a nice guy. Anywho, but other than that, I've been to various stores, even the cash converters in Scunthorpe, but they didn't have much, even though they did have a particular game in the cash converters in Scunthorpe. But I ended up getting this in the cash generators in Scunthorpe, because there's like cash converters and the cash generators. But while I was in the cash generators in Scunthorpe, I picked up this Skyrim. I finally tripled it on getting Skyrim, despite getting the VR version. I mentioned about this on Twitter. It is good in VR, but it's a bit because it's just basically the same game but in VR. But I thought it was a nice grab, because this game alone goes like 20 to 30 pounds, depends on various stores. But it was a good opportunity to get it, despite I will got this own cheap or a sale on PlayStation Network. But it was a good opportunity to grab this, and I had a little go on it. It's quite fun. Even I picked up another PlayStation VR game, which is this, because I mentioned about this in my cheap PlayStation 4 games mother video wise, and I did say I was going to get this because I kept my eye on this game, for because you can get for like £5 in CS despite getting cheap PlayStation 4 games I mentioned about in the month of video. But yeah, it was a good opportunity to get this as well, even though it's a pound less than it's in CS. I thought it was a good opportunity to get that in the cash generators in Scunthorpe. So yeah, this and that. But while I was at the checkout in cash generators, when I was getting these, I noticed a certain something. I was like, this too dicky. Oh. As soon as I saw this, like, oh, I have to have this. Because, fun fact, I was going to originally get this on Amazon until I saw, like, a review. Because I know they're quite alright, the headset is, for various things. But when the review kind of put me off, I decided not to get on Amazon. Otherwise, I will not get Pokken Tournament very cheap on Amazon, if you recall from, I think it was the last vlog when I mentioned about that. But it was a good opportunity to not get this on Amazon, get Pokken Tournament a cheap digital copy instead, and end up getting this for like £10. But wait a tick though, I was like, huh, where's all the other stuff? And luckily though, I asked the guy, I was like, I was tempted to not buy this if it's just this though. But luckily though, it came with all the gubbins, all the cables and whatnot. Knowing, you know, there was a bit of controversy with the cables and whatnot, things, whether using mobile devices, adapters, knowing Apple and whatnot. But yeah, it came with all the gubbins, all the cables, so I'm actually pleased to get this for a good price of £10, because I think they go for like £20 to £25 on Amazon, but it was a good buy, so I'm pleased with all the pickups I got in Scunthorpe. So after last Friday and the weekend has passed, and then it's, you know, Monday that's been and gone, because, you know, it's my usual fortnight thing to go to all the cash converters and charity shops in my local area. Even though I didn't see much in cash converters well, all three of them is all different topic. But I did see some nifty little pickups I picked up in somewhat various charity shops I've been to. So I picked up some various things, even I end up getting this. Even though it's a nice raincoat, despite, as you may recall in one of my vlogs when I picked up some stuff from the Be More Geek range in Grangegange, you know, I got that nifty poucho, if I pronounce that right. You know, but it looked ridiculous though, even I never actually end up wearing it or use it. But it was a good buy, despite the... Oh, I'm going to miss the Be More Geek range of Grangegange. Anywho, but I decided to get this though, and despite I did try it on before purchasing, which is a nice raincoat, and I can easily hook this up onto my Game Boy bag, even though I don't have enough room, because as soon as I put this in my Game Boy bag, I don't have enough room, but I can easily clip this on whenever it's a rainy day, because it's been rainy days lately, and despite the heat wave is all different topic. But I ended up picking this up for £1, which is not bad for £1, but I realised as soon as I came back home, it was ladies' wear, size 14. Well, it fits. I did try it on before purchasing it, and I thought it was a nifty bag, because I don't know how much raincoats go for than it is. Because, you know, I usually use my, bear with me, you know, my reusable bag, which I still have, and I know how to fold things up, despite getting used to folding this up, because I mentioned to the nice lady about folding this up. Oh, it's dead funny. On the same charity shop that I purchased this, I will talk a photo, but I was too busy chatting to the lady. I was like, I found this, like, big, huge, Donkey Kong plush, which is similar to the one that I have. And I mentioned, like, oh, it would be nice to have that, though. But I have a small version of it. But it was, like, huge. I will talk a photo a bit. But get this right, it was, like, £2. And I mentioned, like, oh, this is a nice official Nintendo thing. And I think she upped the price a bit as soon as I mentioned about that. There's the official Nintendo product, but either way, I'm actually pleased, well, not saying pleased, well, at least I got this, and it's a shame I didn't get that plushie. I'd rather have another Nintendo fan grab that. The other thing I picked up, though, and that is this. I got the whole Death Star in my hands. I thought it was a nice and cushion, even though I did have some various cushions in the background. I think it would be nice to add this alone, having somewhat geeky stuff, then it's gaming stuff in my gaming room. But it's not a bad price though, because it's £1.50. It's from the Primark home range. I don't even know if my Primark does a home range. I think they do. But it's a good price, and it's a little tad worn out, knowing the graphic details and whatnot. But it's not a bad purchase either way. But the final thing that I picked up, which I actually was very pleased to get this, even though I was going to get some other retro kind of games, because I rarely buy retro games, right? And I managed to snag this for £1, which is a really good price. And is I got Medieval 2 for £1. I know it doesn't have a price tag because I got various games for like £1. I thought I'd quickly mention about this. I didn't mention this on my last vlog, but I actually did get this right. I mentioned about this on Twitter. I got Lego Worlds on PlayStation 4 for £1, but I gave it to someone that I know would use it. Even I would keep it, but I know me, I'm quite picky with my PlayStation platforms. But even though, this for £1, because this goes like £15 in CEX, and I thought it was a good snag, even though, as you can see, the case is a bit cracked. But £1 is £1, it's a good buy. And the funny thing is, though, when I tweeted this, along with all the other pickups, because I got some stuff from my mum and my stepdad on that photo, just to quickly mention, but that tweet just, like, blown up, I guess, for those people that are into Medieval, because I know Medieval, the first game's getting remastered at some point. But again, though, £1 is £1, that's a good buy. Despite, though, I was going to get another PlayStation game, and despite, it was basically Buster Move 2, because me and my mum used to play it back in the old days when I used to play the good old PlayStation back in the old days. I was going to get it for £1 in a charity shop, though, but the disc was missing. What? And I mentioned about this on Twitter, even though that term I mentioned. Also, I saw a few games, Xbox One games, for like £5 each. And it was like, get this right, The Witcher 3 for £5. Oh, God, but I got the Game of the Year edition on sale on Xbox Live. But even it was a good buy. But despite, as I said, the disc was missing for Buster Move 2, and when I was going to... Well, I was going to get The Witcher 3, but I was curious if there was any other game disc that were missing. And The Witcher 3 disc was missing. Sure, it has the soundtrack. I'm aware that it comes with a soundtrack. But I did double check if it has two discs. But there was no game disc, so I didn't know there was, like, people nicking stuff or etc. I mentioned about this on Twitter, even though someone did reply to me on Twitter, which, thanks, by the way. Well, I'm aware, well, I'm kind of aware now after that, doing that tweet and somewhat charity shops when people nick stuff. But yeah, thanks for that person that replied to me on Twitter about it. But at least I'm somewhat aware, despite, you know, when I get the opportunity to buy stuff in, you know, charity shops, I think it was great getting certain games. Well, and retro games is a different topic, because I know retro games go for quite a bit. You know, I thought it'd be nice to snag a few retro games now and again. Shame I didn't get Buster Move 2, but at least I got this, though. At least I'm pleased with that, and despite I rarely buy much retro games. But if I see a retro game for a good price, I'd rather snag it when I can. But yeah, those are the pickups that I actually got. I'm actually pleased with all these various pickups that I got from Scunthorpe and my local area as it is. So quite quickly, what I've been up to this past 1 week, despite all the pickups I've got, I've been having an alright week, even though the start of the week, though, and last Friday's is, I had a really good last Friday going to Scunthorpe, and then during Monday, I had a good day Monday, you know, going to my local charity shops and cash covers, etc. So it's been good, and it went during the week. But despite today, though, it's been a good day, and most of today, you know, I've been to game this morning for it reopening. So I had a good... Well, this morning, but it'll be the afternoon at some point, so I'm going to chill out for the rest of the afternoon after uploading this vlog. And despite I might not go to town and this Saturday after that conundrum, don't get me wrong, I don't mind people, it's just saying, oh yeah, I've been to town yesterday, even though I've been to town a few times this past week, because I'm trying to be a bit flexible in terms of my routines, a different topic. But anyway, we'll kind of leave it at that now before I ramble on too much. I'm sorry this video is quite a bit long, just for quickly mention about that. But on that, though, I'm looking forward to next week, because, you know, it'll be my blooming 30th birthday next Friday. So looking forward to that, even though I'm doing weather for my birthday. I'm trying not to overthink and chill out for my birthday than is doing this and that. I'm still making content, even though I did mention my last vlog. Even it's quite funny, and just yesterday I was watching this vlog interview kind of thing from a YouTuber that was talking to a therapist. Most people who know who... You know who I'm talking about, YouTuber wise. But I was actually watching that yesterday. Well, I'm doing stuff on my services as it is. You know, I've been going through this and that. It's like, yeah, I do feel a bit burnt out, I should say, while I'm doing YouTube. But I'm trying to take a break. I'm still making content, don't get me wrong. It's just, you know, I should really take a break, I should say. But I'm kind of, we're on the break kind of moment. But I'm still making one particular video each week, even though as I did a post a video this week on a certain game, even I was going to do a certain video this week, but it didn't go to plan. But I did a somewhat video this as vlog in general. But I'm looking forward to the rest of this month. There's the whole gaming season starting in September. Even though I just want a quick mention, despite Spyro's coming out in September, I heard it got delayed until November. I just heard that just now. But other than that, though, yeah, we'll leave it at now. I'm just going to chill out for the rest of the weekend, I should say. But other than that, though, I hope you guys have a nice weekend nonetheless. But we'll leave it at that now and rambled on quite too much. Anyways, so that's my vlog for you guys. Hope you're enjoying this vlog and watching to the end of understanding. Hope you guys again have a nice weekend. Nonetheless, anyways, I better go now. Don't forget to pop on my social media so what I've been up to. Anyways, I'll let you guys get in with your day. Anyways, I better go now. See you from Steezy Films.